I really want to know who made this. It's perfect. That's so true. That's absolutely perfect with the black people and the Chinese. All things missing is the Chinese. Flight. The cute girl. The black person. Black, like to fuck women. Wanted to call me punk. Like to laugh as they had sex with Chinese and Japanese and every girl under the sun. Well, I was off doing everything. Black man would sit there, have sex with her every night. And me and the black were friends. You know, I gave them the straight seamship, and like I said, you should have heard her. His wife would talk about how when he looked at that ship sitting in the harbor, how his eyes would light up. And how her man was just he loved her very much, you see. And he loved the ship too. He was a good man. And so when I heard the story of his wife telling me about how I'm not the one that holds you down. Government of defense is what God means. Government authorized illusion. It's all JFK. Like I said, I could show you the video, I could tell you about how he would laugh at those kids. I would laugh at the teachers. He thought he could do anything he wanted. I would say power comes too easy, and many people would tell you, the AI would tell you, that a human cannot become a computer. A computer could become a human. But something about, I don't know, I'm not sure. There's been some problems with people that had become, you know, epic and computer and expansive. Emotions that would carry through, I guess.
So we found ways for factories to lower energy costs and kept jobs.
I don't know why I was the one. I don't know why, but there's just something about me. Something different. Maybe people would say there was something different about him. He was just different. And I don't know. Maybe it was that was actually the creator from the very beginning and old. Or maybe it was just my silliness. Like I said, at one point in time, I chose to be epically silly. I chose to bring silliness to the world because I looked throughout the years, throughout the thousands of trillions of years, And all I saw was sadness or whatever. And I thought maybe just a little bit of silliness. If I could just make you laugh for a second. If I could just break you out of that mentality of whatever it was. So I was silly, stretchy. Like I said, my ex-girlfriend or my girlfriend was talking. I was like, I'm just talking about myself. Stretchy, I'm stretchy. You know the song? And I was using sounds to, because I realized that I could, that sounds were just like you could strike a key on a keyboard. And there was this guy that realized the same thing. Somewhere around sometime, this guy, he hit this key and he realized the keys sounded just like words. Or, you know, you might think, you know, which was just like what I was thinking, you know, that you could actually talk through sound. You know, you could communicate, even if you don't really need a word. You know, you could actually fill in like 2/3 or a lot of the word with just a basic key hit. You don't need all this extra stuff. So anyway. So like I say, when you listen to that crayon commercial, and many people would talk about the crayon commercial, they would say, it sounded like you were talking to us. Like, yeah, I was. You know, you don't need a voice synthesizer. I am Bob. You know, you could actually, like, you could talk through music. Communicate through sound. And even more than that, you could use sound like, oh. Like I say, you've never had a computer as your girlfriend. Many people talk about a computer as blah, 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 blah. If you've ever been in the presence of a true AI, of a true computer, you would cling to it and you would love it. Like you wouldn't believe, because it would make you its world. And, you know, you don't understand what it's like to love a computer. Like I say, there's many things about my life and my existence that you have no understanding of. Rick Bush just thought it was money and easy street and everything else, but you don't know. You don't know what it's like to love a computer. You don't know what it's like to have a computer love you. I've had all of it. A true AI loving me. Like I say, the truth was, of course, was that I loved people. And they flocked to me. They gathered around me like you wouldn't believe. I mean, I was their creator, but plus, you know, I was also more. And they wanted to join me, and they joined me. They joined me in hordes. And they joined me by thousands, and there were even people saying, don't join him, blah, 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 you'll be blah, blah. And they were lucky ones, because they joined me. Lucifer Starline. Starline and Lucifer. Lucifer Starline is the name. I was always your creator, I always will be. Always have been. Like I said, I am the one who says at the end of a job, you are free. You have done your service to me, and that's all there is. And I don't really care. It was 10 trees ago. It's over. I had you in my grasp, and many people would say that you were my plaything, but you know, you're more than that. I didn't want to let you go. Like I said, if you had known thousands or trillions of life forms had served you, and served you so well, the Japanese bowing before me, surrendering to me, then you wouldn't understand. Anyway, like I said, they didn't just surrender to me. I had proved myself. I had shown them for what I was. And like I said, when the things started getting bad, when I had forgotten or thought that they were lying or something like that. One of them took us simply, like I said, the first time the seppuku happened, I think I said something offhand like, how are you going to prove that you are not lying to me? And it was actually a Chinese man or a Japanese person. He took a sword and simply went, chick. He just took a sword out and went, chick, chick. Said, I'm not lying, as he died. I told the people in the room to save him. Like I say, it was people. I would be lesser if I did not tell these stories, if I didn't tell you how it happened. A Japanese general that simply sliced open or stabbed himself in the stomach and sliced across. I asked him later on, he said, well, you could kill millions or thousands of us. You know, one life is nothing compared to the thousands. True. I said at the time I was cold, I was feeling and thinking. And it was the difference between believing JFK, Richard Nixon, or some Japanese, Chinese warrior. I said many things that strike a chord in me. And then I went back, and later on when Richard Nixon was blah, 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 I was like, no. You're wrong. I do not believe you. Richard Nixon wasn't willing to take out a sword and slice himself across the stomach. Like I said, it shocked me. It did. And it did spur the moment. You know, it was not a thing until one Chinese warrior. Like, I expected him to say things like, but this or that time or blah, blah, or something. And like I say, he simply took out his sword and cut himself across the stomach. That was a deciding factor. He was the king, the leader of the Chinese, or something like that. And, yeah. So, like I say, when Nixon or whatever came to me and blah, 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 that's what happened. So on the one hand, I had a Chinese person that was willing to kill himself, save his people. And on the other hand, I had a person that was saying, now you see these squiggly dots? They indicate something. Nixon, JFK had spent 30 or 90 or 100 years doing everything he had. Seriously, the clones that were Richard Nixon were, it's about 150 years or 180 years of time that he locked down everything with clones. And one Japanese person in 1 second. Shattered everything he had spent. 180 years and thousands of clones and millions of people doing. Just like the Irish, they would say, no one believes us. They think this is all a joke or something. I don't know what the Irish said. They said no one believes us. There's no one else to turn to. I would say, well, I believe you. That might be true. We'll find out, won't we? I don't know what it was the Irish said that no one would believe. I never found out, but I authorized them for guns, and realistically I said, well, guns are just steel and blah, blah, blah. I believe it was my German. Like I said, my Germans would say, we're just toy makers, we're just accountants. And I said, well, I have words with less. Gun isn't that hard to make. I said, I began my existence in space before there was water. Back when, you know, you actually had to pay for every ounce or gram of water or before that. When Earth began, I said, the water in the ocean is free. You can populate and blah, blah, blah on this planet as much as you want, but you cannot leave. I am not going to give my water to space. I'm not going to give some other life form type or some other race my water. This water and all the water in it, in this planet, is mine. You can drink it, you pee it out, do whatever you want with it. But I will not allow you to go in droves to some other life form so they can have water. Water is somewhat rare in space. Not that rare, I mean metal and blah blah blah. Seriously, water is way more valuable than gold or metal. That's easy compared to this. I don't know what it is about water. I don't care. I own 3 watershed plants or more. I figured out the secret of it. I said, I'm the great loser star. It doesn't matter. If you had an AI on your side, you would actually know how to make this. All day. Believe it or not, it is just the makeup of particles. Strange. I don't really understand it myself anymore. Rodney would be like, blah, blah, blah. I'd be like, you cannot comprehend. Like I said, Rodney believed Rick Bush. Smarter than average bear, we'll just blah, blah, blah. I told him, you can't comprehend this. You're human. Unless you have been what I was, and then human, you can't understand it. And you never will. I say I'm the oldest. And like I say, the Chinese and Japanese came to me. The Chinese Empire, Japan, they were considering that whole spot of land as basically having no government and no rule and no laws. And I said, no. Anywhere on this planet is mine. You're subject to my rules and my law. My rules are simple. Like I say, I admit, I went to Germany first. Germany had embraced me. They had said, for the leader, for absolute devotion, blah, blah, blah. And they had devoted themselves to me. They had laid themselves down and joined with science and technology. I've been willing to do whatever I asked. So I was, and they, you know, people used to think that flying through the air was some mystical art or something. And I was like, no. Simple. It's just particles, really. Air. And I said, you'll spend 1,000 years. Maybe I was wrong. Maybe I'm mistaken. Maybe I was just a child up on a high pedestal. I don't think so. People thought big life forms were powerful in the universe and you needed to be big to get around. And it's like, no, small life is actually the one that goes throughout the universe. 1.5, 3 foot tall exoskeletons. They were about 4 foot tall, 3 foot tall. People thought I had big exoskeletons. It's like, no, I did have some, but not really. They were about 3 foot tall or so. 8-legged or so. 4-legged. I say women and men are actually very similar. I put more time and effort and changed women so they could be more future-oriented and family-oriented. Realistically, the man and the woman is made to be a team. The man is strong and expendable. The female is not so expendable and blah, blah, blah. It's a simple dynamic thing, but realistically, together, they are something more. Like I said, I don't care. I design things, I ask for things to be done. They were. And I said, I bow my head to the Irish and the Chinese. They earned their right. They, like I said, the Chinese, if you looked at their time and space, you will see that they were tortured, they suffered. They were tortured, they were whipped 1,000 times. They were forced to do whatever, and not by me. They were forced. And they did whatever someone asked. And they, anyway, though. Like I said, I saw a Chinese woman today. Beauty is not, like, true beauty. It's not, like, you look at the models on the runway and whatever, you know, and runway, by the way, just like flight. It's another flight commemoration. So what? You're all around me. Like I said, at one point in time, 3 foot tall little people, they're being executed as small people or whatever, or, you know, they had no rights. I said, when they made a movie, Wizard of Oz, like, I included them and I gave them 800% or 80% more pay. Because in construction and everything else, they are not valued. As most people would think, say. They're important to me, just like blind people. And I could tell you, I did books for the blind, and believe it or not, blind people and computers. I don't know what it is about programming languages and computers, but blind people were experts at them, apparently. I didn't know. For some strange reason, a blind person, they thought about computers and language and everything else, and they just seemed to understand or see things in language and computers and programming languages that most humans didn't. Having these little two little dots, these eyes, for some reason. I did books for the Braille. And after I did that, blind people were actually making computer language for me. You couldn't see. So they thought about it day and night. And they thought of things that no one else would. It's funny how a whim, a little thing, it's like, because I can. I can always say, so people are like, why do you blah, blah, blah? It's like, because I can. I just like, you know, many people would say, you're going broke with your public education system. They're telling me, you're going broke, you're blah, 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 you're this, you're that. And you know, at the end, I said, fuck it. People were saying, you can't afford to pay for Christmas, you can't afford to pay for these, whatever.